Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about one-on-one roleplay advertising. This is part 4 of my one-on-one roleplay Bible series, and here's where we're going to put it all together. So if you missed the other videos in this series, I do recommend going to watch them. I'm going to make sure that the series of them is linked up in the card so that you can go do that. Okay, so at this point, if you've been following along, you have your whole Bible put together, and it's got your rules, it's got your characters, it's got your plots and settings, your wish list, all of the things that you're looking for in regard to what you want to communicate to others that are potentially wanting to roleplay with you. So now, what do we do with it? If you remember back to my advertising roleplay groups video, you'll know there are 3 elements to a roleplay group advertisement: the visual, the text, and the call to action. The Roleplay one-on-one Bible, in this case, is our call to action. The whole goal with the advertisement is to get people to click that link and actually pick out characters and plots and then message you with their thoughts on what's in your Bible. So how do we get them to do that? Let's talk about those other 2 elements. First, we have the visual. Now, we talked about in my RPG advertising video, this element being absolutely crucial, but when it comes to one-on-ones, this might not be the case. Why? It's gonna be platform dependent. In my experience, people are generally willing to try out a new platform for a roleplay group that they're interested in, but they're generally not willing to move platforms for a particular individual role player that they're interested in. This means that when it comes to one-on-one roleplay, generally, you're only going to advertise on the platform that you're willing to roleplay on. This means that the visual element then is only crucial if it's a normal part of the process for the platform that you're on. So if you're roleplaying on Tumblr, you probably need a graphic. If you're roleplaying on Twitter, you probably need one of those aesthetic pinned tweets at the top of your account. But if you're role-playing on Reddit, just text is fine. So when it comes to the visual element of your advertisement, study what other people are doing on your platform and follow suit. Next, let's talk about the text element. This is the stuff that people are going to read before they click on your link to your Bible. So what should be included? The first thing to remember is, unlike a roleplay group where you're trying to sell people on your moderation team and moderation style, when it comes to one-on-one roleplay, you're selling a potential partner, you. This means it is critical to have high self-awareness. You need to make sure that your advertisement accurately represents what the experience of roleplaying with you is like. For example, you might think you're being accommodating by casting a wide net and saying that you're interested in a wide variety of things, even when this isn't the case. But like we've talked about in a couple of previous videos, this is being passive, so it's not a good thing to attract the right people. In the other direction, being super rigid isn't the best either. Roleplay is collaborative, so some level of compromise must occur. That means we don't want to be so rigid and have this tiny little box that we want potential partners to fit into. This means when it comes to the text element of your roleplay advertisement, you need to sit down with yourself and really think about, when it comes to one-on-one roleplay for you, what is your need to have, what is your nice to have, and what do you not really care about? Once you can answer those questions, you're ready to write your ad. The ad should convey what you feel is need to have. Maybe a few of the nice to have things, but definitely none of the things that don't actually matter to you. And then the nice to have things that don't make it into your ad, that's stuff that you can discuss in DMs with the potential partner. If you're unsure if you did this successfully, show the ad to some of your friends that are currently role-playing with you and know you relatively well. And hopefully you have honest friends and you're asking them honestly, and they can tell you if these are your actual need-to-have things that you're including in your ad. If asking your friends isn't possible for you or doesn't work for you, another thing that we can do is pay close attention to who is contacting you based on your ad, and slowly over time, refine that ad to attract the people you want to attract. Now, I realize this advice doesn't tell you what you should write, but that's okay. What you should write is going to vary from person to person, because what you're selling here is yourself. Think about your need to know, think about your nice to know, think about your values as a role player, and that's what should be reflected in your ad. And of course, at the bottom of your ad, just like when it comes to roleplay groups, that's where we're going to put our call to action. So if we're talking about one-on-one roleplay, that is your roleplay Bible. I would also include a brief instruction, something like, if this interests you, DM me, or whatever, that's so that call to action is perfectly clear. So these are my basic tips when it comes to doing one-on-one roleplay advertising. Now, I know some of you that have been in the roleplay world for a while are probably thinking like, well, she didn't include this or that. So some of those common things that I didn't include, I'm going to go ahead and address those so that you can see why and why you might want to go ahead and include them. So these are things that are commonly seen in roleplay one-on-one advertisement that I don't personally find useful. So the first one is the writing sample. This is a staple of roleplay advertisement. So what does it do? What a writing sample does is it communicates to potential partners your style of writing and helps them understand if you two will click. So that makes sense, right? So then why do I find them not useful? In my experience, they rarely do what they're designed to do. Let me explain. A writing sample for most role players is an example of their best writing. It's generally been proofread and edited many, many times, more so than they would do on a regular post. It also tends to be one of their longer posts, and it tends to be a post that they were particularly proud of, and that's why they included it. What a writing sample is generally not is a window into what an average post is like for this person. Because let's be honest, most people wouldn't do that. They're gonna put their best work forward, of course, because it's an advertisement. So in my experience, what a writing sample really does is shows me what that person values or thinks is important in writing. It doesn't show me what writing with them is actually like. And when it comes to understanding what's important to another writer, I would personally prefer to see that in the rules or something like that where it's explicitly stated instead of having to pull it out of subtext in the writing. Because if they can explicitly state it, that means they're self-aware, which is really good when you're making sure that you're writing with somebody new and you want to know a little bit more about them. So for these reasons, I would say ditch the writing sample. If you want to keep it, make sure that it's in a separate place that you can easily pull it out of when people ask for it, but I would only supply it when people ask for it. The other thing that I've seen a lot that I don't like to include is an About Me section. So why am I not into these? Because they tend to include a lot of information that's not really relevant to role-playing with that person. And if you follow all of my tips on writing your rules and writing the text element of your advertisement, then you're not gonna need an About Me section. If you do want to include one, my advice would be make sure it's about you as a role player. If you're including this because your goal really is to make friends and using role play to do that, and you might need to dig deep and do a lot of self-awareness and stuff to really see if this is why you're doing this, then I would say the more successful method to making friends through roleplay is to be a good role player and put that foot forward and slowly make friends over time. Don't go into it with the conscious goal of making friends. And because you were a good role player first, and that's how they got to know you, that's going to make that bond stronger over time and last longer with that person. So this is my advice when it comes to doing one-on-one roleplay advertisements. If you took nothing else from this, then I hope what you took is understanding that when you're writing that text element of your roleplay advertisement, you need that to be accurate to what it's really like to roleplay with you. That's where I find that most roleplayers are failing when it comes to their one-on-one roleplay advertisements. The advertisement just doesn't describe what it's actually like to roleplay with them. So what other things do you guys find helpful when it comes to one-on-one roleplay advertisements? Let me know down below. And remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for more videos, click that bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching and make it a great day.